as we start to think about what is gut health, one of the fundamentals is the delivery of water. Hydration is a massive responsibility of the colon. Small intestine is where we do a lot of the nutrient delivery that we think of as gut health. And so small intestine is absorbing the nutrients that would become both the micro and macronutrients, things like your minerals and amino acids, as well as then the macros, which would be like your glucose and carbohydrates and your fatty acids and all of this. The colon is where the water happens. So the colon, when it's healthy, has a very high expression of tight junctions, which allow for a high electrical potential to occur across that wall of the large intestine. The colon is where you do most of the water absorption, not just from the water you drink, but from the food you consume. And so the water in all of the food that you eat is extracted during its process or journey through the colon. The higher the expression of tight junctions, the better you are at absorbing water from that food. Leaky gut, which has become popularized in the public now, is the phenomenon of a breakdown in those tight junctions. And when you lose that tight junction integrity, you lose that electrical potential, and now stuff is transiting back and forth across the colon instead of being that unidirectional delivery of water. Water is leaking back into the colon. So loose stools is a very common expression of leaky gut, where you're starting to have a failure of absorption of water from the food and liquids that you're consuming. In contrast, a healthy gut is going to leave you with well-formed stools that are not high in water content because that water has gotten inside of your cellular system. But that's only the beginning of the journey of hydration. Once inside the body, that water has to transit from your lymphatics into the blood vessels and then from the blood vessels into, you know, your circulation with the heart and peripheral vasculature. All of that journey, again, relies on high integrity of those tight junctions and vascular systems. The vascular system is delivering the water, again, to distant organs and deep into tissue through that electrical potential so that it can pull water from the bloodstream into your tissue, into the muscle, into the organ itself, whether it be the liver or the lung or whatever. We pull water from the bloodstream into the cells themselves. The inside of the cell should be 70% water. To get water there, it relies yet again on another electrical barrier, the cell membrane this time, to deliver the water inside. At each of those boundaries, the gut lining, vascular lining, and the cell membrane, it relies on high integrity of protein synthesis, tight junctions, and the like. Ion has been shown to supercharge your body's ability to produce tight junctions at each of those boundary events. And as you increase that cellular hydration, your capacity for detoxification, for nutrient delivery, for revitalization of cell proteins, for the elimination of metabolites that are natural to your daily consumption of calories, all of this relies on the hydration component within the cell. When we look at human longevity as a whole, 50% of it has now been mapped to the density of microbes within your body, specifically the mitochondria. The other 50% of longevity or the aging process is the amount of water inside the cell. So if you have a strong microbiome and deep hydration, your capacity for life is supercharged. Ion is the backbone in which nature does this, from soil systems to the human colon. It is here to produce the capacity of generating water inside the cell. Ion is your connection to hydration.